Hello everyone, welcome back in today's session. So myself Professor M.S. Koite, Assistant Professor of Department of Agricultural Entomology, KKVA College of Agriculture, Nasik. So our course number is Ento 121 and course title is Fundamentals of Entomology. So in today's lecture we are going to study about the body segmentation of an insect. So in general, insect body is divided into series of segments are known as a somite or also called as a metamorphs. Insect body is divided into three regions or tagmata, namely first is a head, then thorax and abdomen. So this grouping of body segments into regions is known as a tagmosis. So first head consists of the mouth parts, then compound eyes, simple eyes means the ocelli and a pair of antennae. So on a thorax, so thorax consists of three segments. So first segment is prothorax, second one is the mesothorax and third one is the metathorax. So mesothorax and metathorax are together known as a pterothorax. All the three thoracic segments possesses a pair of legs and meso and metathorax possesses one pair of wings. Then third body region is the abdomen. So abdomen has 11 segments with genital appendages on a 8th and 9th segment. So this is the figure of general organization of insect body. So let us see one by one. First is the insect head. So it is the foremost part in insect body consisting of six segments that are fused to form a head capsule. The head segments can be divided into two regions. So first is the prosocephalon and second is the gnathocephalon means the mouth. So head is concerned with the feeding and sensory perception. Then six segment of an insect head is the first is the pre-antennary segment. So on a pre-antennary segment, it consists of the appendages like the pair of compound eyes and three ocelli. Then second segment is the antennary segment. So on a antennary segment, pair of antennae are present. Then third segment is the intercalary segment. So on a intercalary segment, single labrum is present. Then fourth segment is the mandibular segment. So in which pair of mandibles is present. Then on a maxillary segment, pair of maxillae are present. Then last is the labium segment. So on a labial segment, single labium is present. So this is the six segment of a insect head. Then next point is the types of head position. So the orientation of a head with respect to the rest of the body varies according to the position or projection of mouth parts. The head of the insect can be classified as three types. So first is the hypognathus. Hypo means the below and gnathus means the jaw. So the head remain vertical and it at right angle to the long axis of the body and mouth parts are ventrally placed and projected downwards. So this is also known as the orthopteroid type. For example, grasshopper and cockroach. Then second head position is the prognathus. So pro means in front and nathus means the jaw. The head remains in the same axis to body and mouth parts are projected forward. So this is also known as a coleopteroid type. And example is the beetles. Then third head position is the opisthognathus. So opistho means behind and gnathus means the jaw. So mouth parts are directed backward and held in between the forelegs. So this is also known as hemipteroid type. And example are the mosquito, red cotton bug and all plant bugs included in a opisthognathus head position. So this is the anterior or the face view and insect head side view. Then sclerite and sutures of the head The head capsule is formed by the union of number of sclerites or cuticular plates or areas which are joined together by means of a cuticular lines or ridges known as a sutures. So these sutures provide mechanical support to the cranial wall. So sclerite means it is a thick chitinous or hardened plates forming units separated by thinner membranes in the exoskeleton of an insect or other arthropod. Next is the suture. So the sclerites separated from each other by means of thin impressed line called as a suture. Next is the sulci, so corresponding to internal strengthening ridges. Then a general insect possesses the following sclerites. So first is the labrum. It is small sclerite that forms the upper lip of the mouth cavity and it is freely attached to the clapeus by means of a clapeolabral suture. Second is the clapeus. So it is situated above the labrum and separated by the frontoclapeal suture and also separated from the genu by clapeogenial suture. Then third sclerite is the prons. So prons, it is unpaired facial part of the head capsule and lying between the arms of epicranial suture. Then fourth one is the genu. So it is the area extending from below the compound eyes and to just above the mandible. So it is separated from the prons by frontogenial suture and from clapeus by the clapeogenial suture. Then fifth sclerite is the epicranium. So it forms the upper part of the head extending from frons to the neck. Then sixth is the vertex. So it is the top portion of the epicranium which lies behind the frons or the area between the two compound eyes. So epicranial suture. So starting from the dorsal portion of the epicranium is an inverted Y-shaped suture known as epicranial suture or also called as ichthyosal line. So the head capsule breaks open along this line at the time of molting. So next is the occiput. So it is an inverted U-shaped structure representing the area between the epicranium and post-occiput. Then next is the post-occiput. It is the extreme posterior part of the insect head and that remains before the neck region. Then 10th sclerite is the ocular sclerite. So these are cuticular ring-like structure present around each compound eyes. Number 11, antennal sclerite. So this form the basis for the antennae and present around the scape. Then the common suture present in a head are the clapeolabral suture. It is the suture present between clapeus and the labrum. Then second one is the clapeofrontal suture or also called as the epistomal suture. The suture present between the clapeus and the frons. Then number 3, epicranial suture. So it is an inverted Y-shaped suture distributed above the facial region extending up to the epicranial part of the head and it consists of two arms called as the frontal suture occupying the frons and stem called as the coronal suture. This epicranial suture is also known as the line of weakness or also called as the ichthyosal suture because the axial membrane splits along the suture during the process of ichthyosis or molting. Then number 4, occipital suture. So it is U-shape or a horseshoe-shape suture between the epicranium and occiput. Number 5, post-occipital suture. It is the only real suture in insect head and posterior end of the head is marked by the post-occipital suture to which the sclerites are attached as this suture represents the head from the neck and hence named as a real suture. Then next is the genial suture. It is the sutures present on the lateral side of the head, for example, genu. Then ocular suture. It is the circular suture present around each compound eyes. Then last one is antennal suture. So it is a marginal depressed ring around the antennal socket. Then second body region of a insect is the thorax. So it is the middle part of the body consisting of three segments. Each possessing a pair of legs and pair of wings on a meso and metathoracic segment. Meso and metathoracic segments together known as pterothorax. So thorax generally concerned with the locomotion. So you can seen image the prothorax, mesothorax and metathorax. So this is the three segments of the thorax. Then sclerite of a dorsal region of a thorax is a tergum or a notum. Then ventral region is called as the sternum and lateral region is called as the pleuron. So this is the diagrammatic representation of showing the notum or the tergum, then pleuron and sternum. Then sclerites of a thoracic segment. The next or a third region of an insect body is the abdomen. So the abdomen in the embryo usually consists of 11 segments. So abdominal segments from 1 to 7 are pregenital segments. 8th and 9th are known as the genital segments and as they form the genital appendages. For example, ovipositor in females and adipose or penis in males. 10th and 11th segments are known as a postgenital segment. The 10th segment in general forms the supraanal plate and 11th segment is represented by a pair of anal cerci. So usually known as a postgenital abdominal appendages, and the first abdominal segment get fused to metathorax forming a propodeum. So abdomen generally concerned with the reproduction and metabolic activity. In case of male cockroach, 11th segment carries a pair of appendages called as a cerci and act as a tactile organ, and in male cockroach it bears a pair of claspers on a 9th sternum known as a styli, which helps to hold the female during the copulation. So this is all about the insects body segmentation or body regions. Thank you.